What's up, everybody? Today we're going to be covering the top 9 things you should know about the Woodlands area, and it all starts right now.
Hey everyone, I'm Brett Wallace.
And I'm Amber Moore.
And we're
your Houston local guide.
So as Amber said, we're here in the Woodlands, Texas, the beautiful city of the Woodlands. Yes. And I don't know if you can hear in the background, but Huey Lewis and their news is playing. So we're channeling our Back to the Future, kind of a throwback here, the movie theater. But yeah, we're at Market Square in the Woodlands. And today we're going to be covering the 9 coolest things, best things
yes.
about the Woodlands, Texas, which is just a beautiful city.
It is. And before we get into it, Brett, go ahead, if you haven't already, subscribe to our channel. Hit that little notification bell. By now, you know we release a new video every single week. Okay, Brett, so starting with 1, let's just talk about where we are in proximity to downtown Houston. We're about 30 miles north, just west of 45. So it's a straight shot down 45 either way to get out here to the Woodlands. And development started out here actually in the 70s.
And 1970s, not 1870s.
Yeah, good point. And they were thinking, hey, is this Woodlands thing going to catch on? Is it even going to make it? Well, we should have invested in some property about 20 years ago, Brett, because if we had, we'd be rich by now. But yeah, so development has been going on here about 40 years. It is just growing and growing. There's over about, I would say, 100,000 people that call this place home. It is gorgeous. It is its own city. So if you're looking to move to the greater Houston area and you're thinking, I don't really need to live downtown, I need to live in the city, but I want just the quality of life with everything around me where I don't really have to go far, this is the community for you. And we are going to be profiling some things as we get through here. Is there anything else?
Definitely, it's considered one of the top ranked master plan communities in the country.
That's right.
So you might as well say in the world, right?
Yeah.
And then if you say that, you might as well say in the universe, right? We haven't colonized Mars yet. Second Mars reference. Thank you. Okay. So, great master plan city. I mean, not even a community, city. Like, it's just unreal.
Yeah.
I'm from the South, and man, I kind of want to pack my bags and move up here.
So I pulled them out north today, so yay for me. Okay, so 2, let's just talk about real estate, Brett. So if you go on HAR.com, which is our local MLS, we are realtors here, so we do help people relocate from all over the world to this area.
Nice plug.
Thank you, Brett. Okay. You're going to see that there are townhomes and condos, a lot of single family homes. And I would say if you're looking at any price point, you're probably going to find it out here. On the low end, you're probably looking at the $200,000. Yeah. Those homes are becoming very scarce because
very small.
Yeah, you can go all the way up to the multi-million dollar point. I actually ran a search last night and I saw a $6.5 million listing. I've even seen them going up as far as 10, 11, 12, 17 million. Okay, at that point, you literally are buying a mansion out here. Okay, so
not a bad rental home.
Yeah.
That's
exactly. And if you're not ready to buy yet, there's actually luxury apartments all around us. They're beautiful. We're helping some people with a short-term lease before they buy. So trust me, if there's something you need out here, chances are you're going to be able to find it. And this is a great community. So 3, we always have to plug this in, is the shopping. And that's actually where we are right now. Like Brett said, we're in the Market Street area. You're going to find all kinds of amazing retailers. Can we have like breakfast at Tiffany's, Brett? I'm just saying.
And let me just say, we had lunch at the Grotto, which is another, that's a different number, but someone, maybe our videographer, came and brought a Tory Burch bag, which I'm being schooled on what Tory Burch is. And so, yeah, if you notice, maybe one of these outtakes or one of these segments might not have these included in it. So, this is
Tory Burch.
Yep.
Thank you.
Those are about 15 minutes old.
Yeah.
So I'm glad my wife's not with us today.
There's Louis Vuitton out here. There's Tommy Bahama. Sunglass Hut, Jasper. I mean, The Gap. I mean, if you need to buy some, you can even buy a Ferrari out here. Okay. I'm just saying. So you don't have to go far to spend some money, you know? Market Street's where it's at. Okay, so 4, because you know we have to cover food, Brett, in every video. You just mentioned the Grotto. That's like one of our all-time favorites.
We personally had to go verify that it was a great restaurant and that we could actually, in good conscience, refer that out and suggest that y'all eat at the Grotto. So, we can do that now. It was great.
It was really good. There's all kind of food out here, like quick serve, casual dining, all up to fine dining. You can get some great steaks out here. Again, we always have to talk about meat. Sorry, we are not vegetarians. But there's something out here for everyone. Quick bites. A lot of dessert shops, like just quick, like soft serve ice cream. Kids are coming out now. It's just a great place to come out with a family or maybe a date night out. It's just really fantastic. Lots and lots of great options. You're going to eat well here, no matter where you are in the greater Houston area, okay? Okay, Brett, so.
Even the entertainment's another one of our points.
Yeah.
Obviously, movie theater. You know, people still do that. You know, it's nice if you're going to a theater and watch on your phone, right?
We'd have to say 6 feet apart.
Especially if you're watching Godzilla vs. King Kong, so.
And actually, I wanted to mention the Woodlands Mall is not too far from here. I didn't touch on that just a second ago, but you'll see people on horseback. The security rides horseback here. So I don't know if that's gonna extend for years on to come, but I feel like we're truly in Texas when we can say security is on horseback, right? Just wanted to throw that in. But there's also Nordstrom's out here for all of you Nordstrom fans, just wanted to mention. Okay,
right.
Let's see what's next on the list.
And number five, let's talk about the Woodlands being a great place to work. Let's talk about employers.
Yes.
It is such a nice, it's a nice feature of the Woodlands that a lot of people can work and have a great job.
Yes.
And also live in the same area instead of having to commute.
That's
Amber?
Right.
Yeah,
there's a lot of big employers out here. So you might have heard of Chevron, Anadarko, Huntsman, a lot of healthcare hospitals out here like Memorial Hermann, St. Luke's. We also have HP Inc. Hewlett-Packard Enterprise is moving out here. So again, like Brett said, there's just a great quality of life. I mean, who wants to commute for an hour, hour and a half a day? Many people in the greater Houston area do that. But if you live and work out here, I mean, your commute is going to be very, very short. And you just have, it's really a great quality of life. And it's beautiful and pristine out here, Brett. So let's talk about where we are actually right now.
Yeah, I think we're on set for the Fast and the Furious 14 because every muscle car around, I've seen Dodge Vipers, Lamborghinis, anything that has a loud muffler system is on Restaurant Row in Hughes Landing, correct?
Yes, exactly.
Yeah, so that's where we're at right now. And it's been spotty shooting here on a Thursday afternoon with all these race cars. But it's beautiful, and there are, again, we've already addressed food, but there's Fogo de Chão, Del Frisco's, and Trulux, all literally, I could throw a ping pong ball at all three of these places from where I'm standing right now. So
yeah.
A lot of choice, great area, and it's just beautiful and very, very scenic.
Yeah, I'm kind of envious of the people that live in these luxury apartments right here, because I mean, they just have their pick any time of day, so.
And the person that drives that.
There we go,
as if on cue, so there goes Vin Diesel. So anyway, let's go on to the next one. We'll go on to number six, the trail system here in the Woodlands. Now, you've probably had more practical experience enjoying these than I have, but it seems like everything's interconnected here, like with shopping, with all the villages and all the little small enclaves, all tie into shopping. And I believe it's the George Mitchell Preserve is over 12,000 acres. And it's just like everything's interconnected and it's very well planned.
There's over 140 parks. So it's very lush and green, beautiful, plenty to do outside. A lot of times clients call us and they say, we want just this outdoor lifestyle, like hiking, trailing, biking. You can do all of that out here without a problem.
Yeah, we just literally had kayakers in our backdrop a second ago, but like I said, the Hot Wheels was riding around, so we couldn't start. But there was a kayaker on a beautiful yellow kayak back there just rowing away like it's the Thames River, right?
Yeah.
Harvard? Wherever, okay. I went to junior college. Anyway, speaking of which, number seven, we're gonna let her address since I'm a JUCO student, and we'll go to art.
Yes,
so,
one of my favorite topics. I always have to feature art in any video I possibly can. So you'll see this beautiful sculpture behind us. There's actually, I think, over 70 art sculptures outdoors displayed within the Woodlands area. In fact, most of the villages where development has happened with housing features an art exhibit. It's, I think, one of the nation's largest outdoor public art exhibits, which is incredible. So there's a lot of places to do Instagram photos. Brett and I actually were doing a couple here. There's a really cool spot down there. They have a fine arts museum. There's a culture abounds. You don't have to go to the museum district, although we love it in town. There's so much of this out here to enjoy. And I really appreciate how the developer has really expanded the arts and culture out here.
And is there some kind of the GLAD culturals, the GLAD art exhibit or cultural or something like that? Anyway, we'll put some links down to some pretty cool stuff.
Yeah.
The only art I know about, and I don't know if they're up here, are tattoo art. I don't have tattoos, but I know a tattoo. I know a good tattoo.
Maybe after this
video.
I know
a good tattoo.
No, I'm kidding.
Yeah, right. So that Amber covered art, and oh my God, number eight's education. So
yes.
Again, I'm off I'm off this bullet point. So education, obviously great schools in the Woodlands, we're kidding, but just highly rated blue ribbon schools, exemplary performance, just great schools. And you probably know a little bit more about this.
Yeah, so depending on where you live, you could potentially be in one independent school district over another. So I know there's Tomball represented out here, Conroe,
Magnolia.
And Magnolia. Yeah. So yeah, depending on where you live, we always recommend to our clients to look at the schools that you're zoned to, look at the ratings, that says a lot. But it's not like, oh, you live in the Woodlands and here's a couple. No, there's many to choose from because the population is so great. There's also private school options as well, plenty of daycares. Some of the employers out here actually have daycares on site, I saw, so you really don't have to go far. There's also college opportunities. So Lone Star Community College has some great opportunities
right,
out
that's
here.
That's right near the Cynthia Woods Mitchell Pavilion.
Yes,
like
exactly.
I was like, how big is this campus?
Yeah, it's
you
huge.
Know? It's crazy.
Sam Houston also offers classes down here. So you don't have to leave the Woodlands and head up north, which is really cool. So depending on where you are in life, whether you have kids or, you know, you're going to school yourself, there's a lot of great options out here for you. So let's see what's last on the list, Brett.
Okay, let's go to number 9. And number 9. Oh, wait, that's 8. Number 9. All right, we're here at the Cynthia Woods Mitchell Pavilion. I don't know if we can see it in the backdrop, but there it is, Cynthia Woods Mitchell Pavilion, folks. This is the venue of all venues for the north side of town. It was the venue of all sides of town until Smart Financial and Sugar Land. Shout out Southside Video if you need to look at another one. This is, though, a little bit different. It's an outdoor venue.
Right.
The pavilion does cover a lot of seats, a lot of stadium seating up front, but then it has an event lawn that, of course, goes up in the back, and it seats about, what, 16, 17,000?
Exactly.
16,500?
Exactly. And it's good that you mentioned the lawn, because if you're just looking for an economical way to get into a great concert, buying a lawn ticket definitely is going to save you a little bit of money. So that's
and a comfortable blanket. Just bring a blanket.
Exactly.
Yep. There you go.
To sit on probably this summer. If it's winter, you might need 2 to cover up and sit on.
Exactly. But it's so beautiful. It's very serene out here. It's in the middle of the Woodlands. Obviously, it's just, it's probably the biggest, I would think, not landmark, but I would think it's like what the Woodlands is most known for. It started in 1990.
That's right.
Was revamped in 1994 to add additional seating.
Yep.
And I believe, like, we didn't see them personally, but I've seen a few people. Kenny Chesney.
Every video.
Yeah, but Cher, Elton John, Bette Midler, the Houston Symphony. Just
huge acts have come through. We've covered this on another video, but Chaka Khan, Michael McDonald, Ray LaMontagne.
Michael McDonald was here?
Oh, yeah.
I always think of 40-Year-Old Virgin when I read, they play Michael McDonald one more time. Yeah. Anyway, movie quote reference. But
all genres, that's the point. You can come out and see anybody you want out here. We brought our parents, our families out here. It's a great time to be had by all. And as you talk about, it's a great area. It's right here in the Woodlands, so plenty to see and do. You can make a day of it. You know, if you're going to come see a concert at night, you can even stay overnight. There's a lot of great hotels out here. So we definitely wanted to profile it because it is a really great destination spot out here.
And again, thank you so much for watching the Woodlands video. We're just going to wrap it here. It's just a great way to end it.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for watching this video. And like we asked earlier, like, subscribe to the channel. And
get our contact information below. Don't hesitate to reach out to us anytime.
See y'all.